What's up, everyone, and welcome to the club. In today's video, we're creating a sketch illustration of the lizard from Spider-Man. Let's begin today's lesson by sketching a circle in the center of our page. We move to a side grip. Let's start at the very top in the middle. It's going to lightly work our way around the left side, coming down and in towards the center. And then we'll work our way around the right side, using these short, choppy lines, and just readjusting the shape of our circle. Now from here, we want to add a guideline coming down the center of our page to help with the symmetry. Starting from the very top, sketch a line coming all the way down towards the bottom of our page. Let's add another guideline on the side of our circle, starting with the left, coming straight down, and we'll do the same thing on the right. And add one more guideline going across the center of our circle from left to right. Now you want to rotate the head forward so the eyes sit along the bottom edge of our circle. So from the center, move over towards the left, sketch a line going up towards the center line. Now you take that same distance over on the right and do the same thing. Let's connect the outside of our circle to the bottom of this line with a straight line. Let's add a fold across the center of the brow. From the center, move over towards the left, curve out, and then bend that up. Go over towards the right, and do the same thing. Now from the inside corner of the eyes, we're just going to tuck this up underneath the brow. Now from here, we're going to tuck the eyes in underneath the brow. On the left side, we're going to step out, draw a half circle, going around, and then up. Line this up on the right side, and do the same thing. From the top of the iris, draw a straight line going out towards the side of our circle. And now we're going to round out the bottom of the eye. From the edge of that line, curve this down, and then bend that in towards the inside corner of the eye. Let's go back to the center, step down, just mark off the bottom edge of the nose with a straight line. And then from the edge of the nose, we'll draw a straight angled line going up and out towards the inside corner of the eyes. Let's leave a gap underneath the nose, step down, just mark off the edge of the mouth with a straight line going across from left to right. And we'll curl the mouth going up towards the side of the head. On the left, curve this out and then up, sort of aiming towards the eye. Then from here, draw a straight angle line going up and out. Let's round out the side of the cheeks. From the edge of the mouth, curve this out, and then pull that back in. Now from here, we're gonna work our way down towards the bottom of the mouth. From these two points, we're just gonna angle this down and in, a slight angle, to right about there. And we'll close the end off with a curve. Let's go back out to the bottom of the cheeks, curve this in, and then down towards the side of the mouth. Now the jaw is going to sit along this bottom corner. So let's go back to the left side, curve the head coming in, and then bend that down. And then we'll round out the bottom of the chin, coming down the middle, and then back up. And now we're gonna go back up and just slope down the shoulders. Starting from the top of the cheek, curve this out, and then down towards the side. Now from here, we're gonna add some detail to the mouth. Let's start by adding a guideline for the top edge of the teeth, starting over on the left side, come down, and then bend that back up. And then from the bottom edge of the mouth, we'll step up, follow that same curve going across. And we'll tuck the tongue in underneath the top row of teeth. Starting from the center along the bottom, curve the tongue going out and up towards the left, and then the right side. Now that we have the building blocks of our drawing, let's go back and lightly erase some of these guidelines. Now that we've established the basic structure of our drawing, we're going to go back in with the tip of our pencil and start adding some details. Let's start with the bottom edge of the brow. Starting over on the left, it's going to round out the bottom, coming in towards the middle. Let's go up along the side of the brow. It's going to round out the inside of the brow, going out towards the eyes. And we'll add a series of folds going up along the top edge of the brow. I'm just going to add one more and just fade that out towards the side. Now going back and just tracing out the upper eyelid. And then tracing out the outside of the iris, just tucking that up underneath the brow. I'm just going to add a small highlight on the top of the eye. Adding the pupil in the center, going in behind that highlight. And then we'll lightly shade the iris along the top, and then just fade that out along the bottom. We're just adding some thickness to the bottom edge of the eye. Just fitting that in. And with the side edge of our pencil, we're just going to add some shading underneath the eyes. Let's darken up the top of the eyelid, just underneath the brow, and then fading that out. And we're just going to carry that shadow across the center of the brow, just underneath. And then again, just fading that out as we come down the nose. And I'm just going to work our way across the bottom edge of the nose. Going across and up towards the nostrils. And just bend the nostrils out towards the side. And then the nose is going to cast a shadow just up above the lip. I'm just going to add some folds just underneath the brow, going in towards the nose. Then just using the side edge of our pencil to give the impression of some shadows. And then just working our way out from the nose towards the cheeks. Now from here, we're just going to add some detail and shape to the mouth, starting from the center. Just working our way out, and then just rounding out the side. Go back and add some thickness to that upper lip. And I'll just go back and just darken up that shadow underneath the nose. Just carrying that shadow across towards the right. Now just roughly blocking in the side of the head and continue with that shadow. Now from here, it's going to continue and add some teeth along the top row, starting with the points first. So just mirroring what I'm doing on the left side with the right. And we'll just tuck the side teeth in behind. Now going back and just lightly tracing out the gum line in between the points of the teeth. And it will just darken up the gums. Now from here, we're just working on the outside edge of the mouth, coming all the way down towards the bottom. Just loosely blocking this in to add that shadow. And then adding some shape to the outer cartilage. And then casting a shadow from the mouth onto that cartilage. Now, similar to how we did along the top, I'm just going to start with the points of the teeth along the bottom. And then just tuck that in behind the side of the mouth. Now, tracing out the gum line. And then darkening up the gums. I'm just adding some of the molars along the side, just tucking that in behind the cartilage. And then we'll just darken up the inside of the mouth, just working our way around the tongue and the teeth. I'm just going to shade the back side of the tongue. It's going a little bit darker along the top. And gradually just fade that out towards the front. And adding some shadow across the side of the tongue. And then the center seam. And go back and add a little bit more shape to the jawline. Just rounding out those points. And we'll shade in the top of the jaw and along the side, and then just fade that out as we come down. Now from here, we're just going to work our way around the top of the head, just adding a few little bumps along the top and then the sides. And we'll lightly shade in the top with the side edge of our pencil. And we'll start with this even shade and then add some tones and detail after. I'm going to go back and add a little bit more contrast around the eyes. I'm just going around with the tip of our pencil and just adding some scales, some various shapes. Just working our way around. I'm just adding a few more cracks across the top of the head. Now we're just going to add a few more minor touches around the head and darken up our shadows, and that's pretty much it. There's a sketch illustration of the lizard. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. If you did, please make sure you subscribe because I'm posting new lessons every single day. You can also drop your request in the comments below. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon.